Welcome to This Week in Combat Sports, where we're looking ahead to this weekend's big fights and some of the bigger news of the day. I'm Drew Goldfarb, joined by Rick Rockwell. Rick, let's start with boxing this week. Two main cards this weekend, the first being the World Boxing Super Series in Scotland. What jumps out to you, stands out to you, piques your interest with this one?
You know, there's some regional fighters on the undercard that could possibly be worth checking out, you know, because they're on the cusp of getting on the big world stage. You know, and then, of course, the two semifinal bouts. In terms of betting value, there's not a whole lot of betting value on this card because I believe the betting favorites are going to win, and the odds are too far apart to where I'm not even sure if it's worthy of a flyer on any of the underdogs for the semifinals. But I am curious to see who's going to win these fights. I pick the favorites to win both of them just because I like their matchups and stuff. More than anything, I'm more excited for the finals of the bantamweight tournament where Rodriguez versus Inoue is going to take on Nonito Donaire. And I've been a fan of Donaire for a while now. He's got a resurgence coming down to the bantamweight. How he matches up against the winner of this fight's going to be awesome. That's where a lot of my excitement lies for this card. But it's going to be – there's going to be a lot of entertainment value. Just the betting value isn't quite there for this one.
All right. Well, in the other boxing card, we got the WBC Heavyweight Championship on the line. Dominic Breazeale challenging Deontay Wilder. The champion Wilder heavily favored to win. How do you feel about wagering on that fight? Is the money line just too lopsided to consider a bet there?
Well, I mean, I believe Wilder is going to win, most likely by knockout in some fashion, either TKO or just a straight knockout. The money lines, you're not going to make much money if you bet on Wilder to win. You know, you bet $1,000, you basically win $100, depending on which sports book you're looking at. $10,000 to win $1,000. I mean, if that's okay for you, then go for it. For me, there's more value in the prop bets on this fight. Whether or not it goes the distance, which I don't believe it'll go the distance. Will it end in a KO or TKO, which I think it will end in that way. Which round it'll end in. Those actually provide much better odds and return on investment than the money lines for this fight. If you check out the preview that I have for the fight, I've listed probably the best prop bets where you have the best chance of winning, mostly based on Wilder winning the fight, which he should, and probably winning by some kind of TKO or KO.
Last question for you this week. We'll turn to UFC. They're in Rochester, New York this weekend with a big headline fight pitting Kevin Lee against Rafael Dos Anjos. At last check, both fighters were posting at minus 115 on the money line. So minus 115 for Lee, minus 115 for RDA. Break down that bout for us a little bit. And is there any other fight on the card that draws your interest maybe to place a wager on?
You know, I had a hard time with this card because I wasn't too excited about some of these matchups. And what's challenging is when you come from like last weekend, when there's more excitement going on in MMA, and then you come to a card where there's only UFC, there's no Bellator, or no other like promotion that has maybe one or two good fights going on, it's kind of a letdown. And then when you look at the UFC's card, I didn't like a lot of the matchups. I didn't find them, at least on paper, to be something entertainment value. And then some of the odds were too far apart to where it wasn't really worth betting on the favorite to win. And the underdogs didn't have a whole lot of chance. It's not worth the risk. So as in a betting perspective, I was not too thrilled with this card in that regard. Entertainment wise, there's a couple fights that I'm looking at besides the main event. You know, I'm looking at the trilogy fight with Lentz and Oliveira. You know, they fought twice before many years ago. And the first fight ended in no contest because of an illegal kick. The second fight ended in Lentz losing by submission. He says he's a new man, he's a little bit better at this weight class. I think the fight could be good. I'm also looking forward to, I think the Megan Anderson-Spencer fight, the women, both of them were former Invicta champs. Spencer actually was holding the belt and decided to fight. UFC gave her a call, so she go in to fight there instead of defending her belt in Invicta. I think that fight actually could be pretty entertaining. I'm actually going with the upset in that one. And then the main event. I think this main event sets up Lee more than it sets up RDA. And the reason I say that is this is Lee's debut in the weight class. He's coming up from lightweight where he kind of went on a run, but then he didn't have as much success against the elite fighters of that division, losing his last fight to Raging Al back in December. Going up in weight, he feels like it's a more natural fit for him. He has the age advantage. He has the athleticism advantage. He has the explosiveness advantage. He has solid grappling skills to counter whatever RDA throws at him on the ground. And I think in a striking advantage, I think at this point in their careers, I think Lee has the advantage over that also. I think he offers great betting value because I believe Lee's going to win. I think it'll probably go to a unanimous decision, but I would not be surprised if Lee got a submission or even a TKO before then. It should be a good fight. You know, RDA is a tough fighter, but he's on the downside of his prime, and I still think Lee has a chance to elevate his game more, to be more successful, especially going up in weight, to a weight class he feels that he's more naturally fighting at. So there's a few cards that I'm really interested in, but I got to tell you, like, the majority of this card is not that exciting on paper, and odds makers feel the same way because they have big betting favorites. So we'll see. You know, just because it looks that way doesn't mean it won't be entertaining. And we've seen already several times this year where you have had numerous clear-cut betting favorites go in there and lose. They get upset. And then when you look back in hindsight, you're like, wow, that was a great card. Going into it, you're like, eh, not too exciting. But you don't always want to throw your money at the long shots and think, oh, I'll take a long shot here or there. Maybe it'll make it more exciting. Maybe the long shot will win. Anyhow.
That's true. The on paper versus the in reality of comparing the whether it's how long shot someone should be considered or how exciting a card may look.
Yeah, I mean, we're looking at entertainment value, betting value, potential long shots, and then just the excitement of some of these matchups. And for the most part, this UFC card lacks in some of those areas. Not to say every fight does, you know, and I certainly don't want to get in there with some of those fighters, even though the odds stink and the matchups stink. But, you know, from a betting perspective, there's better opportunities. Pick your spots on this card and go from there.
I wouldn't want to get in the octagon with any of those fighters, but Rick Rockwell, thank you very much. Be sure to check out Rick's articles on boxing, MMA, and more online now at gamblingsites.org. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe to the Odds on Favorites YouTube channel. I'm Drew Goldfarb. He's Rick Rockwell. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time.